You're stretching. You're stretching. You're stretching. What are you doing, Middle? What are you doing? We're gonna cook now. We're gonna cook. So, guys, for the people that don't know what we're doing today and can't read the title, obviously. Also, is my microphone too loud? Is it not loud enough? Is it okay? Mira is stealing the show, obviously. Was expected, kinda, wasn't it? Jeez, sorry. Oh. Hi, how we all doing? We gonna start, also, I don't know if you see it, but in the corner there's Blinky. We're gonna start with Millionaire Bites, which is the sweets first. Million Dollar Kitchen? Not really, not really. It's a really pretty kitchen, I'm not gonna lie. I love my kitchen. But it's not, like, super, super expensive, but I love it. Mira is a little bit, concerned right now because I'm in the kitchen and I'm talking. That's usually nothing I do, right? So, we're gonna start with Millionaire Bites, which is the sweets first, because it's gonna take a while. And I already prepared something in the morning for the people that follow me on Instagram. They know. I did not know how much work Millionaire Bites are. This is a syrup that I made. It's basically called golden syrup. It's nothing else than just water, sugar, and lemon. It's basically a vegan alternative to, like, honey, but it's not as thick. And I'm gonna need it for the caramel cream. I bought everything already. And, I think we're just gonna go straight into it. The first thing I'm gonna do, though, is one thing I'm gonna do for the lasagna. I'm gonna grate the rest of the parmesan that I have. Actually, I'm gonna do it later. Fuck it. Because it's gonna be wet anyway. I forgot. No. So, we are starting with the Millionaire Bites. If you don't know what this thing is, this is a kitchen machine. It's called the Thermomix. From a company called Fuhrwerk, where you can do a lot of kitchen things in it. That alert? Wait, was there an alert? Wash your hands? Of course I'm gonna wash my hands. I just turned this thing on first. Okay, now, we mix most of the things in this one, because it's just way easier and simpler and faster to make the dough in here. So the first thing that we need to do, I'm gonna try to take you along with me. So now, we're gonna put in 65 grams of sugar. This thing is automatically weighing how much I put in there as well. It's just normal sugar, and I might mute, okay? I'm gonna let the machine do its thing once with the microphone on, right? And then you tell me, chat, if it's too loud. I'm guessing it's gonna be way too loud. And now I'm gonna, so it's like normal crystal sugar, and now it's gonna make it really, really to a fine dust, right? So this is gonna be really loud, guys, so I might have to mute. Now I need to add the flour. So now I can show you, like, the sugar. I don't know if you can see it. It's, like, really, really fine now. Is it too loud? It's not too bad. It's totally fine. Okay, okay. Headset does a great job in filtering out background noise. Okay, nice. I put in a noise gate, so I thought it might be okay, but just wanted to make sure, you know? I don't want to blow you guys up. So now, 150 grams of flour. Right now, by the way, we're making the dough for the sweets. And next, we need 65 grams of, what is it called? Semolina, which is basically grease in German, in case you don't know what it is. Next, we need 150 gram cold diced salted butter. 150 grams butter. Okay, do you need to see me cut the butter? This, let me see if that's gonna be enough. We need even more than that. Just trying. Even more, but we're gonna cut this one first and then see. And honestly, if you have a great kitchen, and imagine you would cook for a woman, like, that would be like a plus plus. You know what I mean? Okay, we got the 150 gram of butter. We add it in. We close it. And now it's gonna get loud again. I'm gonna wash my hands in the meanwhile. And now what it does, it just makes the dough for me. Which is really, really nice. Also, pro tip for me, what I learned and what I do all the time now. What I always do, I always have a towel, a kitchen towel attached to my pants. So I can always like wipe my hands real quick. And I don't have to go back and forth to where the towel is hanging. Done kneading the dough. Transfer it to prepared cake tin and press in firmly. See, and that's the dough already being done. I didn't have to knit the dough. The machine did it for me. How great is that? So basically what we're doing now with the dough that we made, we just press it in the tin. It's our base. This is gonna be the crust of our bites, by the way, in case you're wondering. I'm just pressing this firmly in, and I'm gonna make like a little wall here too. Okay, now we need 120 gram granulated sugar. More sugar, guys. More of the sugar. We're making the second layer now of our bites. 120 grams and more butter? Jesus. Who was it that recommended that recipe? I think it was Custom, right? Custom likes it sweet and buttery. That's exactly 120 gram. Oh my god, look at me. I knew it. Now we need 350 grams of condensed milk, which I also had to get. Because I didn't even know that we have this condensed milk. When will Julia's Cooking Corner be streamed live on TV? That would be cool. For kitchen gadget? I wouldn't even call it a gadget. This is like, you can do everything. Basically, in theory, you would not need a kitchen. You could make almost all your food in there. You can steam veggies, meat, you can make goulash, you can cook rice, pasta, you can sous vide. You can make marmalade in there. You can ferment stuff. You can make your own cheese and yogurt. There's nothing this thing cannot do. We're out in 2020 and Julia is living in 2030. It's insane. I'm not gonna lie. Like, this whole thing changed my life. I'm not even kidding. Okay, so 370 grams of condensed milk. Apparently people use that for the coffee. It's like, for the Austrians, it's like Marisi. So I googled what condensed milk is because I had no idea, really. I mean, the name says it, right? So it's basically just milk where they dissolved the water out of it. So it's like thicker milk, but it is with a low percentage of fat. So it has like 7.5% fat, but it has like also more lactose. So it also means for us lactose intolerant people, this gives you the ultimate shits, right? So just letting you know. And then golden syrup, that we don't sell here in Austria either. So I had to make it myself. So that's what I made today. I also read, by the way, that this is a great alternative for vegans that don't use honey. Or that don't eat honey, obviously, because honey is not vegan. So golden syrup is also something. I think you have it in the UK and in England. I don't know, in other countries, in Austria, we do not have that at all. So I had to make that today in the morning myself. It took me 2 hours. Basically, what it is, it's kind of... Mine is still a little bit liquidy, but once it's sitting longer, it has the consistency of honey. It's so good, though. Oh, my God. I don't know why it tastes so, like... It tastes like vanilla, butter, and sugar. But there is no butter or vanilla in it. Again, like, it's really just water, sugar, and lemon. So I have no idea. And it doesn't taste lemony at all. Next we need... Now we need to put the lid on it. It's getting lit in a basket because it's just gonna... It's gonna need some air to breathe. And now it takes 35 minutes, guys. 35 minutes? Jesus, 35 minutes. And now, in the meanwhile... Is the background noise too loud, by the way? If you want, I can... So now it's gonna make a caramel sauce out of the condensed milk, butter, and stuff. It's Gucci? Okay. So, in the meanwhile... So now we're gonna make our bolognese sauce in the meanwhile for our lasagna, because we are time efficient, so we can multitask, right? So for the bolognese that I make, this is my own recipe, made it up myself, what I use for bolognese, right? We need minced meat. Then I use onion. I personally use usually the yellow onion for bolognese. Then we need a shit ton of garlic. There is no bolognese without good cold pressed olive oil, my friends, which we're gonna put in our pot. Can put quite a bit because we're gonna make the meat in there anyway. So if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm just taking the garlic clove. Where is it? Here. I put it down, and with the thick part of your knife, I'm just squishing it, right? If you do this, it's really easy to get the garlic out of its skin after. Pro tip. So now you just dice off the tip and the bottom, and now, I don't know if you can see it, but it basically falls out of the shell. And you have way less work than peeling that shit off. Small, it's the small things in life, okay? Also, let me see. Ooh, the dough looks already. We have 8 more seconds, but I think, see, I didn't even know the time, and I knew I need to check it. See, that's when you know you're a cook, that you technically don't even need the timers. See this? Now the timer goes off. I legit just checked it. I'm gonna wait like 2 or 3 more minutes. Because it's not fully golden yet. I want it a little bit more golden. It's a little bit yellowy. It doesn't have the goldenness I want yet. It make you cry? Should I? Okay, I'm gonna give you a pro tip how you're not gonna cry from an onion. If you know that you're gonna cook something with an onion, put the onion like an hour should be enough. An hour before you cook. Jesus, I just dropped some. In the fridge before you cut it. And then when it's cold, it doesn't make you cry. Pro tip. You can also just wear googles, like cutting a finger. No, I'm not cutting my finger. You could also wear, like, for example, the diving googles. I don't know what it's called. I'm gonna get the onion caramelized first, like, or like golden-ish with the olive oil before I add the meat. Usually, if I would not make a sauce, or not like a sauce that I would cook for a little bit longer, I would put the meat in before the onions, because the meat takes longer than the onions to cook through. But in that case, the meat is just gonna get a little bit brown in the oil. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the onions golden first, then add the meat just for a short time, and then I'm gonna fill everything up with a tomato sauce, and then the meat is gonna boil in the tomato sauce anyway, so it's gonna be cooked through. I'm not donating to someone who says googles in that way. Is it goggles? I have no idea. Be careful with your knife. Yeah, yeah, don't worry. Don't worry, my friend. This sauce is gonna make a big mess, but I think now it's stopped. Yeah, I think now we're fine. Onion start as well. It's a good thing when you have an induction stove, everything works so fast. I'm just always cleaning up along the way, so once I'm done cooking, I don't have like the whole shit to clean up after, if that makes sense. And you often have like times in between when you cook where you just have kinda, I don't know, 20 seconds of free time or whatever. And that time you clean. That's the secret. So our onion already start to brown a little bit. We want them really nice and glassy. Glassy, is that a word? Like that they're like kind of see-through. Oh, we forgot the... Oh shit, we almost forgot the bottom of the dough. Almost though. Almost. We got it in time. See, it's just nice. It's nice and golden. I think it was perfect. That is gonna be the base for the millionaire bites. And what we're doing in the Thermomix in the meanwhile is the middle layer. Like the caramel layer. So it's basically a shortbread layer followed by a caramel layer followed by a chocolate layer. So now I'm just adding my minced meat to my onions. I have all my trash that I always keep together and always only throw away at the end. So I don't have to fucking do everything 10 million times. So now I'm just trying to like make the mince a little bit smaller and then mix it in with the onions. Sometimes it's depending how much oil you used with the onions. It might be that you have to add some more oil so your meat is not gonna stick to the bottom, right? Like in general with like lasagna and stuff, like you should not be shy to use quite a little bit of oil. Olive oil, that is. So while this is getting its first little browning side, we're gonna add some spices to the meat because we don't want the meat to be bland. So what I'm using first is just salt and pepper. Cat attack? Is Blinky here? Yeah. So, I'm a really salty person, as you know from gaming. So, and you have to think about, like, the sauce is gonna be covering the pasta, and there's gonna be béchamel sauce in it as well. So you can use quite a bit of salt, because otherwise, like, the pasta is gonna soak up a lot of the sauce later. And if you have unsalted pasta, that tastes like shit, right? So you can make the sauce a little bit saltier because there's gonna be a lot of the salt absorbed by the pasta. So salt, pepper. Then what else I usually use for my bolognese, but again, like everything that comes additional to that is just your own question of taste, right? So what I also use is majoran. I don't know what it's called in English. And then thyme. So I'm using quite a bit of majoran and some thyme. Like you can use quite a bit of spice since you're gonna still add some tomato sauce to that later. So we're probably gonna have to add even more of everything later once we try how everything tastes once the tomatoes are added, right? So once we don't see, we just give it a slight brown and then we're gonna add the tomato sauce. What you can also do, like, again, it's really depending what you like in taste, but sometimes tomato sauces can be pretty bland, right? So what I like to do sometimes, especially when it's coming to lasagna, right? I like to sometimes put a cube of chicken stock or veggie stock, depending what you like, in the sauce to give it like a little bit more taste, if that makes sense. Hope that's vegan. Yeah, dude, that pig and beef mince is totally vegan. No, it's sadly not vegan, but I can make vegan recipes as well at one point if you want. Right now, I'm gonna add some tomato sauce, which is just natural, 100% Italian tomatoes. Chicken stock is so salty though. As I already said, like you don't really have to be afraid. By the way, for the measurements, like how much you use of what, I can't really tell you because I'm basically just eyeballing it. And what I always do with the rest of the sauce in the glass, I just add a little bit of water, give it a good shake because there's still good tomato goodness in there, and then just add it in there. Done. And then I later on cook out the glass and I reuse all of the glass bottles and like everything always because I make a lot of things myself and then I don't have to have like a million plastic containers, so I just store everything I make myself. Now we're gonna bring the sauce to a boil. We're gonna put a lid on it and then we're gonna still add some herbs to it as well. Not the dank herbs, guys, not what you're thinking. Let me just find my little lid. It's lit. I'm gonna add some herbs as well. Again, this is completely your taste, whatever you prefer. I'm gonna add some fresh basil, and I might add a little bit of parsley. Parsley is usually not in there, but I still have some parsley left over, and I think I'm gonna use it. Okay, so the tomato sauce is boiling. Now I'm gonna just put it down a little bit. Also, we still have 8 minutes on the caramel. Ooh, the caramel layer looks... Now I'm gonna chop some parsley, some basil. I'm probably gonna make way too much sauce, but that's fine. Like, I can't really make like a really big lasagna since I'm only alone currently. I'm gonna bring the sweets, like the caramel, the millionaire bites. I bring it to my friends tonight, so that's gonna be fine. Okay, so, and also like, I don't know, a handful of parsley, and now I'm just gonna make that small, chop it. Okay, now we're gonna add, our herbs into the sauce. Where did I put my, we can put that down a little bit more. Oopsie, I almost got stuck in the thing. And now I'm gonna try it, and I'm gonna see if the taste is intense enough for me, or if I wanna add like a cube of like chicken stock or something like that. But I think it looks pretty good. Let me try. Let me put my spoon in sauce and try. Really? Now, our second layer for the cake is done. Scatter 80 to 100 grams blanched hazelnuts over the shortbread base. Oh my god. Oh, the caramel sauce looks so good. Jesus, look at this. Look at this caramel goodness. Jesus, it smells like... Let me test. It's super hot, but... Oh. Know what it tastes like? It's like in every chocolate bar, the caramel, but creamier. Like, if you ever had like a warm Mars or something like that, that's what it tastes like. Like, the caramel inside a warm Mars. Like when it's, oh Jesus, this is amazing. Also, tomato sauce is fine as well. Now what we're gonna do with, where are we gonna do this? I'm just gonna transfer, because I'm not gonna make a lasagna that big, right? So I'm just gonna put, otherwise like legit everybody could eat it. So what I'm doing now is I'm gonna transfer, wait, let me take you with me in this. I'm just gonna use that form for my lasagna, so. By the way, in the meanwhile, we let the tomato sauce simmer a little bit more. Oh yeah, the hazelnuts. Sorry. Just need to get going with what I'm doing. Now we need some hazelnuts. Should I let the hazelnuts fully? Putting my hazelnuts on there. I'm not sure if I want to have a whole hazelnut. But I think so. I like the full... You know when you have like... what is it called? Like the chocolate where the full nuts are in? I really like this. So... guess this is gonna be great. Pour caramel over the hazelnuts and shortbread base, spreading out evenly and leave to cool and set. Oh shit, I hope it's still warm enough to do this. Ooh, sorry. Jesus, look at this. I'm just trying to get the rest of the caramel out. Oh my god, this is so good! I wish you could taste that. Like, I tasted it earlier on. Jesus Christ. This is the perfect caramel sauce. I've never tasted anything like this before. Oh my god, it's so good! Like, it legit tastes like in a chocolate bar. Like, but it's super smooth and like almost creamy. Now I'm just gonna eat the leftovers. Oh my god! Oh! Just checking for a dog. Where did she go? Oh no, she's still there. Jesus! Oh. There's so much lactose in there though. I'm gonna get the shits of death from this. Worth though. There's somebody in front of my window looking in, and I'm talking to a camera having a jar of golden syrup in my hand. Now we're gonna make the final layer of the millionaire bites. Now they're billionaire bites, guys. We upgraded. Now we do the chocolate. I'm gonna first of all use the open chocolate I still have, which is pure, what is it? I think it was Belgian. Yeah, pure Belgian chocolate. I have some here. And then I bought some fresh one. Some cooking chocolate, which is gonna be the final layer. I'm just checking on Mila again. Mila! You gonna come in now or no? Come! Come here! Come! Mila! No? Jesus. This dog. Okay, now we need 20 grams of dark chocolate in small pieces. By the way, for people wondering, I'm gonna turn off the tomato sauce. We don't necessarily have to let it simmer for that long. I just really like when it like cooks down a little bit. And it's a little bit more intense in taste. What are you making? The chocolate. Ah, I caught it in my hand. I'm so good. That was close. But holy shit, ninja reflexes. Did you see this? almost stepped yourself? Almost. Good thing it was a small knife, right? That was oof. Not gonna lie, that could have ooh. Imagine that falling really small one. Imagine that falling like into my foot or something like that. Would have been a great IRL stream in the emergency room. Me sticking a fucking 20 centimeter knife in my foot. A little bit too much chocolate, but there's no such thing as too much chocolate, right? Put the lid on it. Now we're gonna chop it. This is gonna be loud, guys. Rip ears, I'm sorry. I told you it's gonna be loud. Last time I did it, you said it was fine and I don't have to mute. Now it's too loud? Now it's too loud all of a sudden, guys? I asked you the first time I did it. I asked you first time, you were like, yeah, guys, it's fine. Oh, it looks like cacao now. Like it's like pulverized chocolate, basically. Pour onto, oh, okay. Okay, we're done. We just need to put the chocolate on the thing now. Ugh. Action camera! Boop! Okay, now we have melted chocolate in here. And that's gonna be the top layer of our bits, whatever. Still some chocolate in there. Oh, look at all this poop coming out. Chopping up some parmigiano. Okay, let's see, we're gonna chop the parmigiano. Close your ears, guys. We're fine, chat. Got the parmesan done. Parmigiano. Oh my god, it was exactly 40 grams! I didn't weigh it, guys! 40 grams! I'm not kidding you, look at this! 30, fuck, now it's 39. Oh, I didn't even have it done. 39, 40. I am the perfect fucking cook, man. Imagine being that good in a kitchen that you take a piece of butter, you need 40 grams, you chop it off, you put it on a scale, and it's exactly the amount you needed. That's when you know that Gordon Ramsay doesn't have shit on you. I need to check on the dog again. Let me taste my sauce now that it has thickened in and absorbed all the spices. Let's see if we need to add some more, or if we're fine like this. I usually eat like at 9 in the morning or something, 10. Fucking great. I can get my lasagna leaves already. Ugh. Obviously. Dark. Only Barilla. Now, we have the butter. And the butter and the flour in there. And now we just add half a liter of milk. For the rest of the béchamel sauce. Lactose free, so I don't get the poopies. A shit ton of salt in there. And I think, I'm not sure, but I usually put some muscat in it as well. Yep. Muscatness. Nutmeg, I think it is in English. What do you mean unhealthy? Of course lasagna is unhealthy. What the fuck do you think? What do you expect? We're making lasagna in a fucking caramel shortbread chocolate tart kind of thing. Of course it's fucking unhealthy. What do you expect? You're just jealous. That's what you are. That's what you are, Aureus. And I can understand. Where do I have my lasagna? My lasagna sheets. Lasagna isn't that unhealthy. Do you know how much cheese and how much béchamel is in there? That's basically just flour, milk, and butter. I would consider that pretty unhealthy, if you ask me. And we also have some shredded mozzarella. I see you, lady. You gonna come in? You're outside for 2.5 hours now? 2.5? Coming? Not coming. My dog is a troll. Oh yeah, I wanted to put some more salt, I think, in my sauce. Now, actually, I'm gonna... Will I? Yeah, a little bit. There's no such thing as too much salt. Also, there's not a lot coming out of my shaker right now. That's it. Béchamel is done. Oh, that's perfect, actually. Jesus, yes. Okay. Now we start filling the lasagna. So you start with a small... Oops. Small... Oops, dropped everything. I have to pour a little bit back, probably. No, not even. It's fine. Small layer of bolognese, so the pasta doesn't stick. It's actually fine. So, first layer is always just pure bolognese. Fuck, that's... I forgot its stupid fucking shape. It's okay. Fuck. That's what I hate about fucking pasta leaves. They never break evenly. Okay. And then, you go on the same way. You put a little bit of bolognese. Bitch lasagna, bitch lasagna. I'm making bitch lasagna today. So, we have a small layer of this. Then, now, we start adding the béchamel. And if you're being really fancy like me, take some parmesan as well. And then, again, pasta. And as you know, we had the broken pasta on this side, right? And here we had the full leaf, so now we're gonna do it the other way around. We put the full pasta on this side, and then put broken ones on the other side, this layer, okay? So we even out the unevenness, if that makes sense. And we can put in, like, all the broken pieces, the small ones. You woke up before Luke? Damn. Why are we evening it out? So it cooks through evenly. You love my tattoo? Oh, great. Which one? I mean, all of them? Just buy things that fits three? Yeah, I know. But the thing is, I'm alone. Nathan is in England right now, so... It would be stupid to make a fucking lasagna for so many people. And the last of the parmesan... Because on top, we're gonna put mozzarella. for the crust. Actually, I think for the crust, we're gonna even let a little bit of parmesan. I think the dog is coming in, guys. I think it's happening. My god, you're coming inside. Hi. I missed you. Oh. It's so good. Thermomix is really expensive, yeah. Oh, Jesus, I dropped some pasta. Good thing I have a dog inside now that's gonna eat it. How much more sauce do I have? I think we're just gonna do one more layer of bolognese and then just make a last one that is basically just béchamel. And the last layer is always, guys, always, please keep that in mind, it's always béchamel mixed with cheese. So it can be like a really good crust in the end. Sorry. Fuck, this tastes so... I'm so hungry. I could lick the whole fucking bowl of béchamel. Now we're gonna put mozzarella on top. A thick freaking layer of shredded mozzarella. Or some extra freaking bellyache. This might boil over. I think I filled it a little bit too much. But at least I made the right, like, amounts of everything. So I'm happy about that. But it might boil over. I think I made it a little bit too full. That's how you make lasagna. Bitch, lasagna. Snack alert. Fuck, I'm so hungry, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you. To myself. Let's eat all the béchamel that's left. Let's get fat. Every time you look my stream, I'm eating. Well, that's because you need to eat to stay alive, and I like being alive, you know? That's a fact. I think we're gonna throw all that stuff away. Do we still have a lot of shit? Alright, we can... Is the millionaire... Oh, it already said... The millionaire bites are done. Chocolate set. We can cut it now. Look at it. I'm gonna cut it and then I'm gonna show you. But it's all set already. You want the dishwasher? That thing? It's fucking great. And then look at this. We have like our own thing on top for what is it called? The small things? Like it's for grannies, you know? So I don't have to bend down all the time and fuck up my back. I'm not sure actually. I might have to set a little longer. No, chocolate is definitely not set yet. Fuck. Yeah, chocolate not set yet, guys. Fuck. Abort! Abort! Oh yeah, that's looking good! I think we're gonna just finish washing everything up and then we're gonna get it out. I'm gonna put that away. I'm gonna get a chair so I can sit here and eat with you. Yep. Be right back, team. Oh, there's the dog. Hi, dog! How you doing, dog? So, now we need to get out the lasagna. Bitch, lasagna! And then eat. Jesus, I'm so hungry. I'm gonna eat the fattest piece. We're not gonna fucking burn ourselves. 4 years, 9 months. Jesus! It's a long time. Oh my god! Ah! Oh! Oh, look at this fucking beautiful. Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Now we need. Okay, now the problem. I'm gonna be honest to you guys. I cannot manage to freaking plate lasagna without it looking like shit. Also, I kinda want some salad. I'm gonna make some salad as well, quick. Are you fine with me making salad, quick chat? My knees. I'm gonna tell you what my favorite dressing is right now. If you want, can make it for you. If you would like, I could actually make it in here right now because it's easier to shake. Jeez. I like undressed salad. Jesus. Okay, so for my salad dressing, what I usually use, I use some oil. I use some balsamic vinegar, dark one. Get it, dark? There was an Italian joke. I use a lot of dark balsamic vinegar. Really like it. Then, really important, you take a little bit of mustard. Don't judge, it's really good. Don't knock it till you try it. A little bit of mustard. And then salt and pepper, and the rest I put on the salad. I just mix the liquids. You can also put a little bit of water to thin it down a little bit. And then you have your vinaigrette for the salad. Sunflower seed oil on it right now. And salt, pepper, and then I have like a salad herb mix. This one. And I have salad on my knife. Lettuce. Okay. I'm gonna take a big piece of lasagna. Okay, now pray for me. Now pray for me that I won't fuck up. I mean, it's probably gonna fuck up, but. Ugh! Oh! Look at it! And now we're gonna eat together. We're eating now, boys. We're eating now. Is that an angle okay for you? I guess it is, right? I'm sort of taking a picture for Instagram. Where did I put my phone? How is the taste? I only had a little piece. But I haven't had one with like everything, with like cheese and a béchamel and everything. Fuck. Guys, I wish I could share this with you. I wish I could. Oh my god. This is insane. Pray for me that the millionaire bites are done. Like, fully setting, you know? Oh, there's a good one. Look at this, guys. So it's shortbread. It's shortbread. With nuts, caramel, and then like a really crunchy chocolate there. Shortbread? Mm-hmm. I like it. Oh my god, there's some thick boys in there. Like, the caramel is soft. And the chocolate is like crunchy. Oh my god. Oh! Anyway guys, I think I'm gonna have to stop now. Because I'm gonna have to get ready. I'm gonna have to play with Mira a little bit before I leave. But I had a really good time today. We streamed for a little bit over 4 hours, just cooking and baking. But I think it was pretty nice, in my opinion. What do you thought, guys? Did you like it? Would you like me to do cooking streams again? So much, guys. We're gonna vote again, I guess, tomorrow or something like that. What you would like to see on the next stream. What you would like to cook. Like, I would love to try new recipes with you and... for example, things that I haven't tried, or if you want to see my favorite recipes, or whatever it is, I'm gonna just ask you what you want me to make on stream. I wish you a beautiful day, guys. I'm gonna be back tomorrow for sure. I'm not sure tonight, probably not really. Tomorrow, as usual. Which games? I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna let you know. Anyway, I love you, and I'll see you again tomorrow.